The fifth and final trend is the impact of arbitration agreements that contain class action waivers. It was manifest in 2021 in terms of the amount of class actions that were disposed of by motions to compel arbitration. It is and remains the best defense and the best weapon in the arsenal of an employer to shut down and limit a workplace class action. I think 2022 is going to be a very interesting year for arbitration issues. The one workaround that the plaintiff's bar has at present is in California with private attorney general action claims that are known as representative actions, where California state and federal courts by and large have said that workplace arbitration agreements with class action waivers can't be used to defeat or defend PAGA actions. And there's been an explosion in the growth of those representative actions brought against employers. But in December of 2021, the U.S. Supreme Court finally accepted a case to decide whether or not the Federal Arbitration Act preempts PAGA in terms of the use of workplace class action agreements with class action waivers in arbitration. That's the Viking Cruise case, and I would expect that to be decided by the spring of 2022 and give some clarity as to whether or not employers can utilize this defense up and down California and bring a halt to these PAGA actions. But on the federal front, depending on who secures control of both the Senate and the House, certainly Democratic lawmakers and the Biden administration, if left to their own devices, would push legislation that would reverse the Epic Systems v. Lewis case from 2018 that inaugurated this workplace class action arbitration defense to class action. So 2022 will be quite a year when it comes to the issue of workplace arbitration agreements with class action waivers.